Hello, everybody. If you can't see on the screen right now, we have the Call of Duty, Cold War Zombies. Don't know what you call it. Trailer. First look. So, let's take a look at it. It's not what I normally content, but let's go.
Zombies. Who could have guessed that when the undead first appeared in Call of Duty World at War, that it would lead us here to today? From that moment, zombies sparked a love for fighting the undead, bringing its unique DNA to the Call of Duty experience. Whether you're playing solo or co-op, working to solve puzzles or unlock Easter eggs, facing wave after wave.
Wait, is it going to be? Please hope to God there's going to be better Easter eggs than Black Ops 4. I played Black Ops 4 Easter eggs and woey. Hoy boy. I didn't play Black Ops 4 Zombies that much, but hoy. They were bad. I'll shut up now.
Wave of the Undead delivers fast, fun action with just one objective. Survive. Black Ops Cold War sets the stage for a new Zombies experience that not only celebrates our entire Zombies heritage, but uses it as an inspiration.
Wait. What do you mean? Are we like heritage? Are we going like Black Ops? Like, fuck, I can't think of it. Are we going to? Are we going back to like do the original maps?
Inspiration to build a completely new chapter in our universe. Today, we cover the characters, the backstory, and weapons with members of the development team, some of whom have quite literally helped to build it one zombie at a time. But first, let's check out the worldwide premiere of our new Zombies gameplay trailer.
What have you done?
Did you get the package? Watch it.
Watch the tape.
What the hell is that?
A machine.
Hold on. Did I just see the PPSH?
The hell is that?
A machine.
Yeah, that was the PPSH.
It's happening again.
Requiem, actual strike team is on the ground.
Investigate the site. Contain the threat.
Roger. Moving.
Let's get the power on.
What was that?
Sometimes I feel I've got to. Get away.
Strike team, report. What the hell just happened?
What the hell?
Take my team.
Let's go!
Push him back!
You want this?
From the sentry!
Wait, is that Nock? That looks like Nock.
Did you see that?
So many Johnnies, so many.
Thank God Juggernaut's back. Hold on. I go past it. Okay, hold the fuck up. The hell is this? A mental pop? The fuck? Okay, that looks like a new perk. Don't know what it does, but you know. Hold on. When the fuck did we get Chopper Gunner? Yeah, what? Hold on, this. When did... I don't... Why the hell is there a Chopper Gunner in Zombies? But okay. Whatever. I played a lot of Zombies. Hold on. I want to go through... What? This looks like a revamped version of the jet gun. To be honest. That looks like a reversion of the jet gun. Why the hell is there a fucking sentry? I'm sorry. This is like seemingly like how in Call of Duty Ghost, and not infected, there's somewhat zombies mode. That's what I'm thinking of. This is reminding me of. There's zombies mode. Because you could have called in, like, a sentry or something else. But you know. It's not bad. It's alright. I guess so. So far. But. And hold on. There's one more thing I want to... So far, I saw Nock. Who the hell is she? Who is she? Okay, there's one. Take my tears and that's not nearly. Is that gonna be like a soul box thing or something? What the fuck is that thing? Confuses the fuck out of me. Okay. We get to play as Woods too.
After so many journeys, so many chapters, with Black Ops Cold War, we're starting fresh, embarking on a completely different story within our universe.
We've got a new story led by different characters. We've got new ways to play, anchored by new ways of progressing. We've got a different time period. Cold War Zombies wasn't just our opportunity to open up a different chapter.
It was our opportunity to elevate the entire Zombies experience. It's a challenge.
Alright, what do you mean by elevate? Huh? Good elevation? Or shitty, like Black Ops 4 did?
Chapter we call The Machine.
Is that the map name, or is it the fucking machine that's
As we set out to build something completely new, we were inspired to pay homage to Zombies' undead roots, to celebrate our origin with one of our most familiar and signature locations.
Nachter am Toten.
Yeah, I could tell it's not... But why is all this fucking spray paint?
We finished a story, but we're still in that same universe, and this is the next chapter.
The very end of Black Ops 4, our characters sacrificed themselves to collapse the multiverse and try and create a singular world where zombies didn't exist. And they were half right.
This is a Cold War story, and it'll be driven by a diverse group of organizations and characters.
Organizations?
Players are part of Requiem, a CIA-backed international response team led by Weaver, a Russian-American who will be familiar to Black Ops fans.
By the time you arrive on the hunt for answers, the machine will have been ravaged by time. On the surface, you'll see a boarded-up bunker, but below the surface lies a nefarious set of decades-old secrets primed to upset the global order.
The players will find themselves at odds with a team of Soviet-led rivals known as Omega Group, who are just as interested in studying and harnessing the power of the unexplained anomalies manifesting.
So, it's basically Knocked, but revamped to have an underground and open area. I thought Knocked wasn't even in Russia. I thought Knocked was in Germany. But I could be wrong.
Around the globe. Beyond these two warring groups, they'll encounter characters with unknown agendas who operate in the field, delivering insights and intel on this new world's fiction.
The intel you receive and recover is a huge component of our storytelling in Cold War. And for the first time, an innovative new intel system will make content accessible on demand anytime.
There's a lot to uncover.
Wait, so instead of like normal doing Easter eggs, just like you have to find all the information first before you do the Easter egg
that no one's ever seen before. Let's get into the gameplay
that starts with delivering all your favorite elements: relentless round-based action, the pack-a-punch machine, power-up drops, the mystery box, along with the return of some of our classic perks.
That's good.
We've also taken a fresh eye to the core game.
Okay, I like how they did to some of the machines. Like, they, right there's the good old-fashioned quick revive, but I like how they
We've also taken a fresh eye to the core gameplay loop to let you drop in and have fun faster than ever.
The gameplay is classic, but it's going to be tonally quite fresh. You'll find our updates this year have focused on one thing above all: embracing what makes some.
Okay, what the hell is that? It's like,
focused on one thing above all.
Right there. Is that like a new trip mine or something? Or like a claymore? Or fucking like the monkey bombs, or is it like that, or
embracing
else?
What makes zombies so much fun?
That starts with progression. This year, we've unified progression and loadouts across all of Call of Duty Black Ops.
Wait, so if I'm understanding this right, you could have like you could be playing multiplayer, but leveling up your guns and zombies. I don't know about that, Chief. Like, I get it. It's easier, instead of making people, like, grind out guns and zombies, to grind them out in multiplayer, but, and it grinds out in multiplayer and zombies. So, if you get kills in zombies, is it, like, less XP if you kill zombies? Or is it same amount of XP you would get if you played multiplayer?
That means wherever you play across multiplayer zombies, your global rank and weapons level stays connected.
You'll be unlocking weapons and equipment, score streaks that will be usable across the...
Alright, how the hell do you get the score streaks? Is it like, you need to kill this amount of zombies to get one score streak? I don't know about that. Like, I don't think those score streaks... There wasn't score streaks in Black Ops 2, Black Ops 3 zombies. I don't think there's any in the other zombies, but I could be wrong.
Entirety of the game.
No more starting with a pistol. Bring in your AR, your SMG.
What the hell? What about Mustang and Sally's? Like, if you pack a bunch of starter pistols, it's always OP. Like, it always gives you Mustangs and Sally's, or a version of that.
Whatever you're feeling.
And with all weapons boasting rarity with power levels, you can continue to increase your gun's damage potential however you choose.
Wait, are they going to do double pack? Or triple pack? That's going to be amazing if they do that, but I don't know.
Every gun has a path to become an uber weapon.
You'll have a lethal, tactical, and support slot. Not only can you craft, pick up, or find equipment and support in zombies, but you can now use them in combination, which delivers some insanely fun moments.
Traditionally in zombies, the only way out was death. A new exfil system...
Or you finish... where you finished the Easter egg. That's how you finish.
What was this?
Things get tense and the squad is in trouble. You have the option to exfil to a chopper and earn some rewards, but only.
Wait, was that a nuke?
Squad is in trouble. You have the option to exfil to a chopper.
Bitch.
Things get tense and the squad is in trouble. You have the option to exfil to a chopper.
Is that a nuke? Or, like, was building of a nuclear warhead? We, like, going to blow it or something at the end of the Easter egg or something? That would be nice.
Earn some rewards, but only if you can survive a few more rounds of zombie spawns dialed up to 11.
This is shaping up to be a...
So, if you spawn... If you do the exfil thing... And you survive. You just have to survive like a couple more rounds of like round 25 zombies instead of whatever round you're on or something like that. That seems alright, I guess.
The most epic zombies experience ever.
For the first time, post-launch content is going to be free. As new maps come out, everyone...
Okay, that's... Well, are they going to have, like, freaking variants behind paywalls or something? Because I don't want to... Oh, that's going to be gay if they do that.
Everyone's going to be able to come along for the journey as we take them through this storyline.
Lastly, canon is canon. And we've put a story to rest. But as you comb through this new universe, don't be surprised if some things don't want to stay dead.
This is the most connected and robust zombies experience in history. It also delivers a first for zombies, a fully cross-play experience with progression systems that tie zombies to the battle pass. We're dropping free post-launch zombies content to the community for the first.
So they're going to be like two battle passes, or is it just one battle pass? Oh no.
Time as well. We're honored to have you with us on this journey. We're glad that you could join us for today's first look.
Well, hold on. Oh, it has to load. So, is that like a name or something, or like a country? Because that doesn't look German or English. It more looks like Russian. I know it's Cold War era, but I didn't think Nacht was in Russia. It could have been on like the border of Germany and Russia, but isn't Germany like fucking far away to Russia? Hold on. Time to go on. World map. It might be closer than I'm thinking. No, it's not. Because give me a normal map. I don't care. Oh, motherfucker. So, no, it's not, because... Whatever. You zoom in. Here's Germany. Here's Russia. Because you got Poland... Some other countries, don't know how to say them. That one, Ukraine. There's Germany. It might be, I don't know. But That's what I'm just thinking about, like...
Universe.
On that, are they trying to make like another version of the Wonderwall? On like they shoot it and it takes out all the zombies. The Wonderwall only had a certain amount of like zombies it could take out of, but I don't know. And the pistol thing, like, when he said, instead of going in with, like, I think it was this guy.
With a pistol.
Yeah. Instead of going in with your pistol, you can go in with your fucking LMG, your shotgun. Are they just going to, like, nerf? Because I don't know if they're going to keep only certain weapons you can go in with and keep certain weapons in the box. But... they do that. I don't know. Because I'm just going to pack out an LMG and an assault rifle with me. I don't know. But I wanted to cover it because I saw it on my page, like, on when I woke up this morning. So, I thought you guys would enjoy this better than something else. So, the new series will start Friday. This will go up Thursday. Yes, Thursday. And I hope you guys enjoy this video. I know it's not something that normally we would cover on the channel, but I enjoy Call of Duty. I want to be streaming it like as a chill stream. So we'll be doing that for like content wise. And I love zombies. I love playing Black Ops 1 Zombies, playing Black Ops 2 Zombies, Black Ops 3, 4, we're not going to talk about them. I played doing some of 4 I enjoyed, but most of it I did not enjoy. So, I'll talk to you guys later, and peace out, my friends and fellow nerds.